what I do before I drop a song.
Huh? Wait, what?
Let me try, okay? I think it's a bit advanced.
Welcome to Senior Tribe. I'm William Wan. We have a special guest today who's going to teach me how to DJ. Xavier, what's your DJ name?
My DJ name is DJ Ling.
DJ Ling. Yes. Oh, I'm going to have my own. Can Wan.
These are the things that I will bring usually to all my sets. If you look on the screen, right deck is the one at the bottom, and then the left deck is the one on top.
When I was introduced to the console, I thought it was quite complicated.
Our volume faders for this knob control the bass of the song.
But after he explained to me,
one special knob is called the filter knob. Bring it to the right, the high pass filter.
It became quite easy to understand.
What we're going to do is we're going to echo out, and then we bring the fader down, then we're going to press play on this song. You can pick it up. Feel that it's echoing, right? Bring this down. We use this to transit between songs. As a DJ, I actually took about 1 year-ish playing the club. Uncle Wan, he don't really know the song structures. One more chorus. It's not something that everyone can pick up so quickly. With time, Uncle Wan will be able to identify the song structures on his own. There's actually a special button. It's called a sampler. Press this also.
Wait, what?
It will make random noises. This one also. Yeah.
What was that?
Rose, Rose, I love you with an aching heart. Boy, is your future. Now we have to part. Standing on the jetty as the steamer moves away. Flower of Malaya, I cannot stay.
It's a blast today to learn from Xavier, seeing how a DJ can hype up the moods of the people. If you're passionate about something, you make the world more interesting. In terms of difficulty, I rate DJing 3 out of 5. If you love music and you have a rhythm, this is a good activity to learn. Stay tuned for another episode where I will dive into another adventure.